I am Kiki. I have received professional first aid training. Let's search for the injured in need of help. When the earthquake struck, I fell down and got cut by the glass on the ground. Don't worry, I am coming to give first aid. Put on protective gloves and apply pressure with a dressing on the wound to stop bleeding. First, go to an open and safe area to ask the doctor to give you further treatment. Let me help you clean up the wound. Saline solution. Apply from the center of the wound and move outward. Iodophore. Iodophore can kill bacteria on the wound. Put on protective gloves and apply pressure with a dressing on the wound to stop bleeding. Apply from the center of the wound and move outward. Iodophore can kill bacteria on the wound. It's still quite dangerous at the moment. Stay in the emergency shelter and don't run around.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. How should we perform first aid for forearm bleeding? Let's review. 1. Apply pressure to stop bleeding. 2. Ask a doctor for cleaning up the wound and disinfection. 3. Wrap the wound. First aid for bruise. 1. Clean the wound with saline solution. Disinfect with iodophore. Let's search for the injured in need of help. Oh no! He seems to have gotten electric shock. Let's get professional staff for help right away. When a power line falls on the ground near you, it creates a step voltage. You need to hop on one foot immediately and stay away from where the power line falls so you won't get an electric shock. The firefighter boots are made of special rubber that can stop the flow of electricity and offer protection against electrical shock.
Do you know what tools can be used to pick the power line? The iron rod. You are right. Dry wooden sticks can stop the flow of electricity. The on-site environment is safe. I have received professional first aid training. We can start the rescue now. What's the matter? What's the matter? Someone, help me! Please help me call the emergency number and get an automated external defibrillator, AED.
Okay!
If the chest doesn't rise for 5 to 10 seconds, it indicates that the injured has the cardiac arrest without breath. Start cardiopulmonary resuscitation, CPR, immediately. First, unbutton the shirts of the injured. Fold your hands at the center of the chest, lower half of the breastbone. Press down firmly to carry out chest compressions. Perform 30 chest compressions. Open the airway. Then, perform 2 rescue breaths until the automated external defibrillator, AED, is available.
We've got the automated external defibrillator.
Turn on the defibrillator and operate according to the voice prompt.
The cardiac rhythm is being analyzed. Do not touch the patient.
Please leave immediately. Tap on the electric shock button. Great! You are awake! Once the medical team is here, we will give you further treatment. Don't worry.
What are the first aid procedures for cardiac arrest? Let's review. 1. On-site evaluation and examination. 2. Call for help. Dial for emergency medical services and get AED. 3. Perform cycles of 30 chest compressions and 2 rescue breaths. 4. Carry out electric defibrillation. Let's search for the injured in need of help. When the earthquake struck, I fell down the stairs and can't move now. Don't move. I'll get medical help.
We are professional doctors. You can leave the injured to us.
For someone with spinal injuries, improper move or handling of the injured can be very dangerous and may exacerbate spinal injury. You must ask professional medical staff for help.
First, transfer the injured to a long ridge board by using the whole body turnover method. Drag the fixing strap to secure the injured.
We'll send you to a nearby hospital for treatment.
Okay, thank you. How should we perform first aid for spinal injury? Let's review. 1. Do not touch the injured. Ask doctors for help. 2. Elevate the injured by the whole body turnover method. 3. Fix the injured. 4. Send the injured to the hospital. Let's search for the injured in need of help.
When the earthquake struck, my hands were cut by falling stones.
Don't worry, I am coming to give first aid. Put on protective gloves and apply pressure with a dressing on the wound to stop bleeding. Great job! The bleeding stops! Wrap the wound with a bandage. Sprained ankle. Take the disposable medical ice pack out of the tear open the inner bag. Shake the ice pack to cool it. Wrap the ice pack with a towel and put it on the sprained ankle to reduce the swelling and pain. Drag the bandage to fix the wound with the figure of eight bandage method. Elevate the injured foot to help with ankle recovery. Do not exercise after the sprain, otherwise it will affect the ankle recovery.
Okay, thank you, Kiki.
You're welcome. How should we perform first aid for finger bleeding? Let's review. 1. Apply pressure to stop bleeding. 2. Wrap the wound. First aid for sprained ankle. 1. Put ice pack on the sprained ankle. 2. Wrap the wound with figure of eight bandage method. 3. Elevate sprained ankle and do not exercise. Let's search for the injured in need of help.
When the earthquake struck, I got hit in the head and the hands by a flower pot. It hurts.
It's dangerous here. Let's go to an open and safe area, and I will perform first aid on you. For head injury, apply pressure with a dressing to stop bleeding. Fold the bandage or triangle towel. Drag the bandage or triangle towel around the head to fix the dressing. A bone that pierces through the skin indicates an open fracture. A bone that does not pierce through the skin indicates a closed fracture. The injured suffer from a closed fracture of his hand. For an open fracture, bandage it as a closed fracture before fixing the fracture. First, protect the arm with a soft cloth. Then, choose a magazine, a brand, and finally, secure the arm with a bandage. Be careful not to wrap it too tightly. You need to go to the nearby hospital for further treatment.
Thank you very much, Kiki.
You're welcome. How should we perform first aid for head injury? Let's review. 1. Apply pressure to stop bleeding. 2. Wrap the wound with a triangle towel. First aid for closed fracture. 1. Fill with soft cloth. 2. Secure with a splint. 3. Wrap with a bandage. 4. Suspend with a triangle towel. Let's search for the injured in need of help. When an earthquake strikes, natural gas pipelines are damaged. The leaking gas ignites due to the spark of the electrical appliance and starts a fire.
What shall we do?
Make a wet towel first. Covering your nose and mouth with a wet towel can filter the smoke out of the air and reduce the intake of toxic gas. Check if the doorknob is hot before opening the door first. In case of fire, touch the doorknob with the back of your hands.
Ah, it's burning hot!
The door is burning hot. That means the fire is coming our way. Keep the door shut. When trapped indoors by fire, you should immediately call for help from balconies or windows.
Help! Help!
Do not call out for help for too long. Keep your strength up and wait for rescue. Touch the doorknob with the back of your hands. If the doorknob is not hot, then check if there's smoke in the corridor. If there's no smoke, evacuate as quickly as possible. When the fire breaks out, you should find an emergency exit sign right away and follow the directions to evacuate as quickly as possible. Drag the injured and follow the direction indicated by the emergency exit to locate the exit. After an earthquake strikes or a fire breaks out, it's dangerous to take the elevator. Let's take the stairs. My arm was scalded. It hurts. I am coming to give first aid. Rinse with clean water to cool the wound. Cut off the clothing near the wound. You need to go to the nearby hospital for further treatment. Okay, Kiki, thank you so much. You're welcome.